Hello everyone, it's Vicky and I'm so beyond excited. I just met the postman at the door and he brought me a box. And inside of the box was this beautiful, beautiful binder. And I'm so beyond excited. I was gonna wait a couple of days to film this for you because this is not officially a review, but I thought I would kind of do an unboxing on this because when I was in search for this, I didn't see all that many. I saw one or two. This is a Kikki.k planner, and there's a ton with this mint color that have the diamonds on there, but this is not that one. This is just one of their kind of 18-month perpetual calendars that's not the day timer that they are like. Everyone has either the lilac with the diamonds on it or the mint one with the diamonds. This is not that one. It's a little bit of a different one that they had on their site. And I didn't really see all that many reviews on this or initial unboxings. So I started opening it and thought, I really, really want to share this with my viewers because it is so exciting. It's very beautiful. It smells like, it has a leather smell to it. I'm just going to share smells with all of you, but it also has a chemical scent, which to me just means that it's probably the dye that they use to dye the leather, because obviously leather does not come in mint green. So they do claim and say that their leathers are real. And I also found, which I didn't know, it came with a little card. This is actually my first Kikki.k purchase, and I really honestly was hesitant to purchase from the company just because I had shared with you many videos back that I had reached out to the company's customer service and had asked several questions stating that I am a YouTuber, that I do want to order. Not that I want their products for free. I didn't say that. I just said I want to order, but I had a few questions before I decided to order from them, and kind of I didn't get a response that I was really happy with, meaning they didn't really explain anything. She just said, here's a link to our site and a few videos that explains it. And I was looking for a more personal touch as far as customer service goes, but you guys are enablers and you enabled me and said, hey, you know what, perhaps it was just one bad egg. It's a great company. There's tons of products that they have that are wonderful. I've worked with so-and-so and I've worked with so-and-so, and they were really kind and worked with me. And so I took your word for it and decided to go with it. The reason why I purchased one of these was because I wanted to go back to the binder system for some of my planning, and I will have all of this in an updated video, but this honestly is just going to be an initial reaction on this. But I just wanted to let you know that with all of the planner anxiety and everything that I had, I have one A5 Filofax, and that's my hot pink domino, but thought I wanted to go the leather route. And when I saw this on the Kikki.k website, I just fell in love and really wanted to get it. So with that said, there's a card in here that I wanted to share that I did not know this, because every video I've seen with Kikki.k, I've never heard anyone say this. It does say that the Kikki.k planner is handmade using natural materials, which means no two planners are the same. Due to the nature of the leather, there may be some slight irregularities in the leather color, size, and grain. Each item will have natural signatures like wrinkles, blemishes, and other markings. You'll also find your Kikki.k planner stylish cotton lining, so it's a cotton lining inside, is screen printed by hand to ensure each planner is beautifully unique. So I've never seen anyone share that in any of the Kikki.k videos. And a lot of people complain about the leather and that there's indentations and the color is off and that there are markings and that they're very disappointed in saying that it is very cheaply made. For me, honestly, looking at this, and I will flip you guys over in just a second, I do not think that this is cheaply made. I do not own a leather Filofax, but A5 size, but I do own a Malden, and I will not say that the Malden is any better as far as aesthetics go and the Kikki.k. As far as how they hold up, I will definitely share that with you moving forward, but of course I just received this literally in the box in the mail and wanted to share kind of initial thoughts with you. So with that said, I took the plunge, decided to order from Kikki.k. It was a very fast shipping. I ordered this on Thursday evening and it came to me Monday morning. So that is very, very fast. And I live in the States and they're sending from Australia. I know they're a Swedish company, but I believe that the store is based in Australia where they sent it from. So that is a very, very quick shipping. That was not expedited shipping. It was just the standard shipping that they offer. So I'm going to flip you guys around and show you what this looks like up nice and close and personal. So as you can see, the journal came, or the, I apologize, the binder came in a beautiful box. It was wrapped in a beautiful package in a larger box. Everything was bubble wrapped and very much protected. And when you open the box actually has a very pretty little band around it, which I love detail, and I love when companies put this much focus into their wrapping, because you are paying a decent amount of money, so it should look very pretty. It just says leather personal planner, and customize your own planner to suit your lifestyle and live an organized life. The little box on the inside, how gorgeous. It says today is a good day. Just love the details. It's a very nice box. This comes wrapped around the personal planner, and it just says leather personal planner. It says it's an 18-month perpetual calendar. It has to-do lists, my day notepad, meeting note pages, 4 blank tabs, line notepad, 3 sticker sheets, and pockets and loop, and then just has a very pretty picture. So that was wrapped around it, and then it was also wrapped in tissue paper and then placed very nicely in the box. So I'm very, 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 very impressed with how that was wrapped and how beautifully that was shipped to me. Now, the leather on here, not sure if it shows up perfectly on camera, but the leather is a beautiful mint green color. It is not the robin egg color that is very popular in the Martha Stewart collection. I would say that this is much more on the greener side, where the Martha Stewart collection for Staples, most people are familiar with the color that she uses, and that color is more of a blue color. This is definitely more of a green color. The leather on this feels like pebbled leather. It is a very soft leather and feels very much like a pebbled leather. The closure is a snap closure, which is beautiful. I have not owned a snap closure, and this is also in the A5. The Kikki.k website refers to this size as personal, which in the Filofax world, that would mean that it is a, you know, a smaller size, but in the Kikki.k world, it says personal, and this is actually more of an A5 size. The snap closure is beautiful. There's a very pretty gold button here, and the gold detailing is very stunning. There is stitching around the binder, and it seems like a very sturdy little clasp. There is a little K emblem on the clasp itself. As you open the binder, there was a little silica pad that was in here, and then you have your, which comes standard, I've seen in most of these binders. Excuse me, I'm trying to catch my breath here. I'm trying to say everything as quickly as I can to kind of help protect during shipping. I will definitely be removing this. And then I'm going to move you over to one side here. And on the left-hand side, what I received was a little notepad that says today, and that's just slipped into the pocket. And then these are information sheets. This is a great little size just to jot down a couple of notes. You have pockets that are in here, and the pockets are not very deep. They're about as deep as you see wide, so they're all about this deep as far as pockets go. But they work great for stickers or little washi tape or anything like that. This little card says, I'm unique, and that is what I read to you on the back here about the planner and how they state that they're handmade and that they are all different. On this little sheet, all it says is how to open your binders using the little clips on the, at the top and at the bottom, as well as closing. You just close shut by pushing the rings together. You have a secretarial pocket right back here, so you can slip any larger pieces of paper. And then you have a really nice zipped up closure, which I really appreciate because I like to carry stamps with me in these types of binders, as well as some cash, and this is just perfect. It is as deep as the entire width that you see here. That's as deep as the pocket goes. Very nice zip closure. And the pretty little detailing, it is like a gold color. It is not heavy. It feels a little bit on the cheaper side as far as metal goes, but it has a nice gold kind of zipper to go along with the colors. Again, a very pretty stitching. I really enjoy seeing that. This pocket also behind the zipper opens and is the entire length of this kind of mint green section. And so you can slip other papers in there as well. This, as the card states, is a hand, it's cotton, and it's also hand, let's see, it's cotton lining, and it's screen printed by hand. So that's what this is, and it does feel very, very delicate. What people were complaining, that you can see indents and things of that nature. It is very delicate, and it does feel very, very delicate. So we'll see how it withstands the true test of time. The The rings themselves are in a silver color. I think it would be really beautiful if they were in the gold color, just to kind of go along with the other hardware on the binder, but that's okay. They are all very tightly shut. I don't see any gaps or any spaces in any of the binder and bindings themselves. There are six in here. Then this is absolutely stunning, I must say. Just the presentation of this is absolutely beautiful. The colors just kind of complement the pastel type of a binder. I have seen these in the berry color, navy, and then I just saw that Kikki.k released a beautiful, beautiful tan leather with navy, and that was definitely on my radar as well, and very stunning. But this is just coordinated so beautifully, and the first tab that they have here is calendar, and when I flip it, it is a beautiful, sturdy, it feels like a plastic cardboard almost, because you can see here it's shiny as it catches the light, but it's a very sturdy divider. Nothing on the other side, but it is that plasticky material, so people who like to sticker save and things of that nature, I think this would work just fine for that without you having an issue of removing your stickers. They also include these beautiful stickers. I mean, these are truly very pretty to fit the tabs as well as numbers. There's blank, there's to-dos, to buy, action, to read, top three, top five, follow up, remember, favorites, priorities. I like the numbers a lot, and there are three sheets of those, which those are very beautiful. I really like that they included those stickers. Personal information, as well as blank calendars, which is fantastic because that means that I can start this calendar whenever I need to. The pages are most definitely on the thin side. There will definitely be bleeding and shadowing because the paper is extremely thin. I would not say that the quality of this paper is high quality, but also Filofax is not high quality. So I will most likely be printing my own, but this is really, really nice that they are undated. I do like that. The paper is very nice and smooth, so I would imagine if you're just using a regular ballpoint, you will not have any issues. If you're a fountain pen user, if you use an extra fine nib, I will test this later, but I would say that if you use an extra fine nib, you should be okay on this paper. But if you use a very wet fountain pen, there's no way it'll survive. The next tab that they have placed in here, so these are all just blank months. The next tab here is a beautiful peach color. It is fairly true is what it looks like on the camera. It matches that silk screen down here at the bottom. Beautiful color. It states meetings, which is very nice, very professional. I worked in the corporate world for a little while. To have this laid out on your desk is very beautiful. It just has tons of blank pages that have meeting notes, and at the top here you have your subject, your attendees, the date, and the location, which is honestly very key in a meeting. Anytime you're taking down minutes during a meeting, this is very, very important. You want to know who your attendees are, what your topic is for your meeting, and so on and so forth. You know, my days, honestly, back when I worked in the corporate world, I could probably fill this up in about a month or so because there are just so many meetings that you hit up in an office job. So that's really beautiful. Again, the paper just feels just very divine, very smooth. And then there's a beautiful gold. It's a very old school, old yellow type of a gold color, which is very nice. It's not that bright yellow gold. And this says to-do. You get plenty of to-do sheets in here. I mean, this is a good chunk. I would say that's a good moleskin volant or a moleskin K here amount of paper that you receive on the to-do. It is lined. It is not lined all the way across, though. It is lined, and it is lined into two sections, which is very nice. So if you're making lists, works beautifully. Very well thought out. Then as I flipped it, you'll notice it's a very pretty pink, almost lavender color divider. And there is nothing here, so it's to my discretion to fill that. And sorry, that's Hank, my dog. And then as we go along here, again, these are just like the meeting minutes. Or meeting notes. At the top you'll see a subject, a date, and then it has lines all the way across the page for you to fill up with notes in here and such. As we keep going, the dividers are beautiful. They do repeat themselves as far as color goes, and they're just filled with blank sheets of paper, which is great, great, great for taking notes. I think definitely geared for a professional kind of mind because of all the note taking and just the professionalism, I think, of the way that this looks. at the very end here, more note pages. Again, I would say each of these sections that contain the notes papers are about a moleskin K here, or moleskin volant notebook. You also get a pad of paper that is just placed into the back, and you can see the beautiful silk screen back here. I do see a little bit of a marking on here. No big deal. I mean, I think that'll happen. Do I love that there's a mark in there? No, but I'm not too upset about it. It is definitely because of the silk screen. I am familiar with that material. It is why you can definitely feel some of the bones, I would say, or the structure of the binder underneath. If they had put the leather in throughout, it would probably A, raise the cost of the binder, but B, you wouldn't feel the bones of your binder. And then there is a really nice little pen loop that is also attached here. I would say that it's a good size pen loop. I don't think you have to be using too thin of a pen to go in there. And then this probably fits any kind of really standard notepad in the back. And then the back has a really beautiful gold label back here that says Kikki.k. So it looks very, very professional and beautiful to carry around, whether you leave it on your desk. It looks very pretty on your desk, or if you carry it around in your purse. I just think it's a very lovely, lovely binder. It is not heavy, and it is a fairly thick. You can see that it is filled a fairly much, probably to its bulk. Actually, no. I could probably fit a bit more in there, but it isn't heavy at all. I do understand why people say that it feels a little bit cheaper than the Filofaxes, and I think it's mainly because the interior has that silk screen instead of the leather throughout. I think if they added the leather into the inside, it would definitely add the cost of the planner, but it would probably feel a bit more firm in your hands. I can see that there is some give, definitely, to it, so it's not completely stiff or, you know, anything like that. It definitely has some give to it, you know, but I think for the price, it's definitely a fair price to give to this planner, because I do think it is very, very pretty and professional looking. And so that is the inside of the book. So that was the inside of the Kikki.k planner. I will definitely, most definitely, have updates for all of you, as well as an update on what I was feeling with my planning anxiety and what I have done moving forward and what I will be using this for. But I just wanted to just share in the joy and excitement of receiving something in the mail and just loving it. Just loving it when you get something this pretty in the mail. It's just very, very exciting, and I thought I would share the unboxing experience with all of you. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave comments and questions, whatever you'd like, in the bottom. I absolutely adore hearing from all of you. Thank you so much for your love and your support, and I'll see you guys again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.